Jesus, we gather before you today to celebrate and commemorate the 50th graduating class of Faith International University, the class of 2022. Lord, we thank you for your goodness and your mercy. Surely they will follow us all the days of our lives. We thank you that we serve you in this educational ministry that was founded on the inerrancy of the Word. Father, today in society we are besieged with headlines that say, up is down, left is right, good is evil, and somehow that we are supposed to question your truth. But you did not come to save the righteous or the religious. You came to save the lost, so that we may be found righteous in your sight. For the graduates sitting here today and those watching online, we applaud the diligence of your studies and the perseverance of your hard work to finish strong in all that has been set before you. Lord, would you pour out your blessing, your favor, and your anointing upon this commencement ceremony, that your name would be lifted high and that your glory would consume us even beyond these walls. We worship you, we praise you, we magnify your name. The name above all names, in Christ's glorious name we pray. And all of God's people said, amen. 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 The next voice you'll be hearing is the Reverend Dr. Ron Bamey.
Yeah, would you all please stand for the reading of God's word together? Sorry, we put you down too quick, all right? As I was praying about a scripture for you, our wonderful graduates, I felt God bring to mind a passage in Revelation almost just instantly that I felt applies to you and to your generation. It also means an awful lot to me because in my Bible, the very first one I was ever given by my grandparents, one of the verses was underlined. And the older I get, the more important that verse becomes. It's Revelation 2:10. I also remember being in Western Turkey and standing right there where these words were shared. And they were true then to the people of that time, and I believe they're true to you today as well, as God applies it to this generation. Amen. Revelation 2, verses 8 through 11. And to the angel of the church in Smyrna write, the first and the last, who is dead and has come to life. He says this, I know your tribulation and your poverty, but you are rich. And the blasphemy by those who say they are Jews and they are not, but they are the synagogue of Satan. Do not fear what you are about to suffer. Behold, the devil is about to cast some of you into prison, that you may be tested, and you'll have tribulation. 10 days. But be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. And to him who overcomes, he will not be hurt by the second death. Amen.
Be seated. Blessed good evening. On behalf of the Honorable Governing Board, the distinguished faculty, and the acclaimed administration, It is my great pleasure to welcome you to the 50th Annual Commencement of Faith International University and Seminary. Now that deserves some applause right there. 50. From 1973 until 2022, we have produced over 3,200 alumni who are serving Christ around the world. And I thought about that a little bit the other day, and I thought, I'm amazed that I have participated in 35 of the 50. So I'm getting up there a bit, but what a joy it's been to see so many wonderful disciples of Jesus, men and women, go out to serve Him. Our 2022 graduates represent, of course, a very scholarly and a noble group of Christian disciples who have grown strong both intellectually and spiritually. They are students who have been diligent in their studies to show themselves approved. They are graduates of a seminary founded 53 years ago and built on the inerrancy of Holy Scripture, and they will continue to uphold faithfully the Word of God in whichever capacity the Lord ordains. Our school is built on the legacy of many, but none more so than that of our late president and founder, the Reverend Dr. R.H. Radall, a longtime visionary pastor. Our commencement will run smoothly this evening, and it will zip by because I like these things to move along. But thanks to the efforts of Dr. Andrew Kyanin, Mary Valoney, and Diane Zetterberg. They're the people that will make this thing move along so sweetly. Now, there are two things I inevitably say at our annual commencement. If you've been here in any of those, you've heard it. The first is for the graduates. It was said years ago by Thomas Gillespie, the former president of Princeton Theological Seminary. He said to that graduating class, "The world is not waiting with bated breath for your arrival upon the scene." As a matter of fact, for the world, the opposite is true. You live to serve Jesus Christ and obey the Word of God, no matter how much you may offend the world. And trust me, you already do. And although the world may not be excited for you, heaven rejoices and hell trembles. And the second thing I always say is for those who are in attendance tonight or watching via media, I know why you're here. You're here to celebrate, that is, make some noise, clap and cheer with gusto when you hear that special name called. I encourage it. The graduates have earned it. And because we will call each name, even though some are in absentia, I still encourage you to cheer on all. Our graduates have plunged deeply into the Word of God. They know that God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him, not a rewarder of those who casually inquire about Him. And let me say this, God is pleased with the efforts of our graduates, so we're going to boldly cheer them on. And one aside to the graduates, remember this, you have completed a dream, but it's not about dreaming. It's about doing His will. It's not about your view, it's about God's vision. It's not about your aspirations, it's about His accomplishments. And it's not about a commencement, it's about a command. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations. Disciples, the Greek word mathetes, meaning pupil or learner. You students, create more learners and followers of God and His Word. So, ladies and gentlemen, I hereby declare that we are in celebratory mode. So may God be praised and glorified, and all we say and do, thank you for being here. Amen? Amen. I now ask that the Reverend Dr. Kyuhyun Lee, Executive Vice President and Dean of International Programs, bring a brief greeting as well.
Thank you, Dr. Adams. Greetings. Welcome. Class of 2022, especially you. We welcome you to come this far. And we also welcome families and friends who've been supporting them for them to go through their works, of course, academic works, to finish their pursuing degrees. So this is a very, very important and meaningful moment for them and for you and for also our faculty and staff, not to mention our board, to support us to maintain or exercise our important functioning in enhancing the kingdom of God. We've been through quite a bit. Without saying much, already we know. Yet, those men and women actually work so hard at home, at library, or in between wherever they were going, they worked hard to come this far. So I commend them for their achievement. This is the ceremony to confirm their victorious achievement. Why don't we give them a round of applause for them? How about faculty who are working so hard to teach them to come to this far? Please. And also this institution, educational institution, has been maintained and supported by our board of directors. So let's give our thanks to them also, please. It has been one of our traditions that for me to say a few words in Korean before this congregation and also whoever watching this ceremony online, I'd like to say something in Korean. So I am going to exercise my gift of tongues, and you will exercise your gift of translation. So I leave that matter to God and to you. 반갑습니다, 여러분. 환영합니다. 특별히 오늘 졸업을 하는 우리 졸업생 여러분들, 여러분들의 수고와 노고를 치하하고 그리고 이 매듭을 통해서 여러분들이 하나님 나라 확장에 더 큰 역사를 이룰 수 있게 되기를 간절히 기원하고 응원합니다. 그동안 수고 많으셨고 그리고 여러분의 많이 쓰셨습니다. 지금 함께 질문해야 될 것은 바로 이제부턴 또 무엇이? What now? Wow, you catch that, right? What now? 이제부터 뭘 해야 될 것이냐는 거죠. 무엇으로 하나님께 영광을 돌릴 것인가? 그것을 더 심각하게 생각하고 새로운 계기가 되고 새로운 출발이 되어지기를 우리 주님 예수 그리스도 이름으로 축원합니다. 그리고 가족 여러분들, 친지 여러분들 함께 응원하고 지원해 주시고 옆에서 참아주시고 필요한 것 채워주시고 하신 모든 수고와 노력들에 대해서 감사의 말씀을 드립니다. 이 해가 50주년 기념 졸업식입니다. This is semi-centennial celebrating year for us. Wow, all of a sudden you catch this again too. So meaningful. Think about all the years. Think about all the years that we have gone through. Although I've been with Faith Seminary, now Faith International University, over 26 years. And I remember a whole lot of things, challenging deals and satisfying achievements and all the tears and the laughs. Yet my conclusion in wrapping this, I give all the glory and honor to our Lord Jesus in heaven. Thank you.
We've asked one of our graduating students to bring a charge to the graduates tonight, and as he makes his way up here, Dr. John Wheeler will introduce him. So make your way up.
Thank you, Dr. Adams. This is something so special. As our lives crossed, and I began to become acquainted with the newly ordained Jeffrey Mathis, over a decade ago, this is my first impression of him. My son was walking out of a first grade class, and I saw this gentleman beelining across the parking lot. I'm like, oh my goodness, there must be an emergency. No, he was going to go pick up my six-year-old son, throw him in the air, spinning him around and catching him as he lands in his arms. I knew there was something special. We all know that there's something special about this man. He's gone from an academy here in Tacoma, where he launched out to the University of the Nations, YWAM Kona. It's my honor and my privilege to introduce to you the Reverend Jeffrey Mathis from Cape Town to Korea, and from Kona, hailing from Tacoma, Washington, the Reverend Pastor Jeffrey Mathis.
I don't know if I earned that introduction. Can you guys hear me okay? Good, good. Well, I'm so honored to be here. Really, this is an honor. As John was saying, you know, I grew up here in Tacoma, Washington, and part of my story is when I was going into my junior year of high school, I think I had about a 1.3 accumulative GPA. My future was dipping fries at McDonald's. Like, that was about the pinnacle of my life. At least that's what my teachers thought. And to stand here today, graduating with my master's degree, I hope I get to go back to Curtis Junior High and tell all my teachers, look how far I've come. But I wanted to open up, and then I want to give an encouragement to our graduating class, but I wanted to honor Dr. Adams, Dr. Wheeler, for everything you guys have poured into us. I was told Dr. Wheeler this before I came in, and said, I'm going to give all the credit for my marriage to Faith International University. I was a brand new YWAM student in Kona, Hawaii when I was 19 years old, and there was this beautiful girl that was new on campus. And I remember sitting down with her, and she's talking about theology. She's talking about dead theologians. And I'm like, this girl is something special. And so we begin to talk back and forth, and she's dropping names, and I'm like, how do you know who they are? No one knows who they are. And I say, have you ever thought about going to school before? And she says, well, I've always wanted to finish my education. I said, oh, really? I'm in my bachelor's degree right now at a university in Tacoma, Washington. What do you think we sit down and grab coffee and we talk about it? Little did she know we were going on our first date. And all through our dating process, we were in our undergrad together, and every once or twice a week, we'd go down downtown Kona to a coffee shop, and man, I would win that girl's heart over, and she'd become my wife. We'd have two beautiful kids. So I just want to say thank you to the faculty for my wife. Thank you. Thank you. But I want to give a simple encouragement. I want to read out a scripture out of Matthew 9. In Matthew 9:35, it says this, Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. And when he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them, because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. And then he said to his disciples, and I believe he's saying this to us today, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask of the harvest. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into the harvest field. And I want to give a simple encouragement to our grads and really to everyone here, as I'm coming as someone who's a young millennial, almost Gen Z, to say the harvest is ripe in the next generation. And I believe that there's a generation that is starving for truth. They are starving for hope. We could turn on the news today, you could turn it on tomorrow, and we're going to see the same thing, is that we have a world that needs hope. We have a world that needs the gospel. They need saving faith that is only found in the person of Jesus Christ. And I want to give us a little bit of statistics. I want to paint a picture of Generation Z right now. Barna did a study out of 69 million teens and children, and only 4% of them had a biblical worldview. Only 4% of them would say that the Bible is of ultimate authority in their life. Only 4% would scroll through Genesis all the way to Revelation and say every single word, every single page, every letter, I apply that to my life. Only 4%. A majority of Gen Z believe that happiness comes from financial success. And how many of us know that that is not the case? That peace that surpasses all understanding only comes from the presence of God. As Psalm 16 tells us, in His presence is the fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore. It doesn't come from monetary things. It doesn't come from things I can feel and things I can touch. The only true happiness I can find is at the foot of the cross. Seven out of 10 Gen Zers believe it is acceptable to be born one gender and to feel another. We're not here to talk about these different things, but this is to paint a picture. My friends, they lead a suicide prevention ministry called Stay Here, and they tell me that every 4 seconds someone commits suicide. There. In the span of our time here, I don't know how many young people would end up committing suicide throughout the world. We need the gospel in the nations of the earth. I am here to tell you, class of 2022, that Gen Z needs your voice. We are not here just to walk across the stage and have a diploma and smile real big and say, wow, look at my accolades. That the whole purpose that we would become educated is because a generation desperately needs your voice. Whether you have your bachelor's degree, whether you have your master's degree, whether you have a doctorate, this generation needs your voice. My generation needs your voice. And so if I could give you one thing here, I want to give you some hope for Gen Z. 70% of Gen Z feels they have a moral obligation to do something to change the world. Why are there riots? Why are there protests? It doesn't even matter what we're protesting anymore. It's just, we just want to protest. Because we feel in the deepest part of our heart that we have to do something to change the world. As pastors, as leaders, as educators, that should get our hearts stirred. That we have a generation, 70% of them, that are ready to change the world. They just need to be pointed in the right direction. This is an amazing thought right here. 52% of young Christians see themselves as potential missionaries. And you brought a YWAMer here. You brought a missionary here, so I can't not talk about the nations. Today, 3.2 billion people will go to sleep not knowing Jesus. There's 400,000 missionaries currently on the missions field. And I believe the number, I might get this wrong, so don't quote me, but it's between 5 and 10% are working amongst those 3.2 billion people. You know, I didn't get my master's in math, but I think the equation there equals to about 20,000 to 40,000 missionaries that are for 3.2 billion people. But I hear statistics that tell me that 52% of Christians in the largest generation feel called to be potential missionaries. I believe we could see the missions force doubled in this generation. And that does not happen without your voice. That does not happen without your voice of encouragement. That does not happen without your voice of reason. We need your education. We need your Bible knowledge. We need everything that you have studied for. I have hope for this generation because of who I see in this room. I have hope for this generation because people still believe the Bible is true. And as long as people still believe the Bible is true, a Jesus movement is right before our eyes. As long as we see, as long as we hold the Bible as ultimate authority in our lives, I believe a Jesus movement is on its way. And so I am here tonight to tell you that I believe a Jesus movement is on its way to Generation Z. And my invitation to you grads is, would you step into a Jesus movement in this generation? Would you find a young person to pour into? Would you find a 13-year-old, a 14-year-old, a 15-year-old to pour your life into?
All right.
Grads, would you stand? I want to pray that a grace would fall on you for Generation Z. Whether you are the youngest person in the room or you know that you are in your latter years, I believe now more than ever you are called to Generation Z. And that there would be an anointing on your life to reach the next generation. Your churches, your jobs, that God would begin to give you downloads and blueprints on how to reach the next generation. So I would like to pray for you. Is that okay? And I will conclude with this. Father, we thank you for this group of grads. And Holy Spirit, what you did on Lauren Cunningham, that you gave him in the midst where no one was believing that young people could go to the nations. You put a dream in a man. You put fire in his heart to see that dream into fruition. And now we stand here, 5 million students going through YWAM schools. Just as someone who's standing in as a YWAMer, someone who's standing in, who's under the leadership and anointing of Lauren Cunningham, I pray an impartation to reach young people. A grace to reach young people. An anointing for Gen Z. An anointing to see bonds broken. An anointing to heal the sick, to raise the dead, to cleanse lepers, to cast out devils. Father, I pray an anointing over this class. That they would not shy behind their education, but they would move in the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Father, anoint this group of grads in Jesus' name. Use them to usher in a Jesus movement in Gen Z. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, let's hear it. A little more applause for that. If he weren't already ordained, I'd ordain him on the spot. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Let's get ready to... We won't go that direction. But we are going to rumble just a little bit. So, I would like those receiving the Bachelor of Arts degree to please stand and make their way toward the stairs. You can make your way there. I'd like our faculty and board to stand as we can greet these graduates as they come through. I will call out our names. Now, we have some, as I mentioned before, that are not here, the Latin in absentia. We won't be saying that. But what I invite you to do is every name I speak or yell out, whatever, that you would cheer for those. Okay? Okay, we'll do that. All right. Let's try one. Just one, okay? Let's try one. Here we go. Ready? Okay, here's the name. Kimberly Ann Adams. That's my wife. She didn't know. I'm going to be in trouble when I get home. All right. Okay, our first recipient, the first three are not here, but then we'll move on with that. Receiving the Bachelor of Arts in Business, we have Daniel Richard Nyquist. Andrew David Trogan. Labria Richard Trufant. Receiving a Bachelor of Arts in Education, Mi Ok An.
An Mi Ok.
This way, meet all the faculty. Say hi to all the people that tormented you for all those years. Receiving the Bachelor of Arts in Leadership, let's hear for Cameron J. Burke. Our next recipient is Jenny Brooks. Our next recipient, Ezekiel D. Carlson. Let's hear it for Nikki Kiyakona. Next recipient is Lauren Michelle King. Let's hear it for Deborah L. Kruckenberg. Our next recipient is Christina Lee Lacey. Let's hear it for Heather Lanning. Our next recipient is Ruth Wanjiko Njiji. Let's hear it for Matthew Aaron Thompson. Please applaud for Luis Rivera Zayas. Receiving the Bachelor of Arts in Religion, Joel Raymond Boggs. Our next recipient is Connor Buck Kuykendall. Let's hear it for Angela K. Kim. Eric Jason Lyons. Antonio P. Marino.
Receiving the Master of Arts in Christian Counseling, Jennifer M. Bartlett. Receiving the Master of Arts in Counseling and Care, Heather Arlene Cummings. Joanna Johnston. Brian David Rogers. And Christopher Thomas Shea. Definitely. Receiving the Master of Arts in Education, Su Il Bay.
Hey, Su Il.
Young Hae Kim. Yoo Hyun Kim. Now presenting the Master of Arts in Leadership Ministry, Shutong Han, Hong Tu Shun. Xiong Tammy Tan. Tammy Xiong Tan. Also receiving the Master of Arts in Leadership Ministry, Zhao Hu Kai. Kai Zhu Hao. Now presenting the Master of Arts in Theological Studies, Jason Bradley. Selena S. Hill. Q. Ho Lee.
E. Q. Ho.
Wei Han Liu. James Owen Ludlow. Alvin Malave Jr. Jeffrey R. Mathis. And Peter Yang. Now presenting the Master of Divinity, John E. Bradburn Jr. Jae Choo Kim.
Kim Jae Chul.
Caleb David Shuey. And Eric G. Williams.
All right, we now have those receiving doctoral degrees. If they would please stand and make their way up. And at this time, allow me to introduce our the Director of Doctoral Studies at Faith International University. He'll have just a couple things to say. That is Dr. James Tilley.
The professional doctoral programs are the pinnacle of academic excellence at Faith International University. They each bring personal, pastoral, and professional growth for the candidate as he or she performs intentional, informed, and integrated studies and a practical application through ministry or service. All of the doctorates culminate in a field research project and report to expand the kingdom of God through demonstrable change in transformational leadership for ministry and marketplace ministry or service. The doctorates at Faith International University require the ability to think critically upon the depth of the theological basis of the field research project, and then be able to apply theoretical knowledge in an integrated, practical fashion for the glory of the Lord. I wish to congratulate all of the doctorates and graduates of the Doctor of Intercultural Studies, Doctor of Ministry and Transformational Leadership, and Doctor of Strategic Leadership. We are now honored to conduct the traditional doctoral hooding ceremony to celebrate the arduous work involved in professional doctorates and recognize the graduate as a new professional doctor. As the Director of Professional Doctorates, I will now hood each graduate, and the doctoral program coordinators will adjust the hood. Once again, I congratulate all.
Receiving the DIS, the Doctor of Intercultural Studies, Beniam Habthermeniam. Receiving the D. Min, the Doctor of Ministry and Strategic Leadership, Vun Yi Bin. Receiving the D-Min in Transformational Leadership is Rachel A. Mason. Receiving the D-Rel, the Doctor of Religion, Jeffrey L. Treadwell. Receiving the DSL, the Doctor of Strategic Leadership in Global Missional Leadership, Chun Weng Boon. Receiving the DSL in Organizational Leadership and Counseling, Monique Renee Jordan. Receiving the DSL in Organizational Leadership, Galia Moldagulova. Receiving the DSL in Counseling, Monica Renee Vasky. Receiving the DSL in Global Missional and Organizational Leadership, Cynthia J. Wood.
And let's hear it once more for the graduating class of 2022. Come on, make some noise. Come on. It's always been our tradition to close our commencement ceremonies with singing of the Lord's Prayer. And for many years, it was sung by the Reverend Dr. R.H. Radall, who was the lead tenor in the St. Olaf Choir. I don't know if you know what that means, but you can have a good voice and not even make it in the choir. He's the lead tenor, and his two of his sons are here, Mark and Paul, are members of our board, and they are going to sing that song. And accompanying them will be everybody's best friend, Adam Barta. And so let's greet them. After the song is over, you will hear a recessional, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. At that, the faculty will begin to descend this direction, head straight up the middle. The students will let the last faculty, they will follow. Don't tackle any of the students on their way out, please. Let's get all the way out to the foyer and then come greet them. Amen? Let's listen to the Lord's Prayer.
There we go.